Namaskaram girls. Till now we learned market structure and pricing. Under the heading of market structure and pricing, we learned what is market, where the word market derived from, and the classification of market, isn't it? Under the basis of area, time, quantity, and composition. And we also studied about the perfect competition, features of perfect competition, and how the producers get equilibrium in a short time. Now we are going to get the study producers equilibrium in long run. As I said, during the short run period, all the other factors are fixed. Only few factors, one or two factors, can be variable. The remaining factors will be constant. We study. So in the short run, we cannot change. The demand can be changed, but the supply cannot be changed in the short run. So short run supply curve will be almost vertical, isn't it? Now we are going to see the producer's equilibrium in the long run. At first, how it will be, and how it becomes long run, how the producers will get equilibrium, that we are going to learn today. First, you have to draw the x-axis and the y-axis. In the x-axis, I am going to write output quantity. The y-axis I am going to write price. Here I am going to mark 200, 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200. The quantity produced. The rate 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. In the short run, demand may be vary, supply may not be vary, isn't it? At the price of 8, the starting price of the product is 8. At the prevailing price of 8, the quantity demanded is 600. So at the prevailing price of 8, the quantity demanded is 600. So the demand curve, and this would be the supply curve. Because in the short term, we cannot change the supply, so the supply curve will be like this. So the meeting point of demand and supply will be equilibrium point, isn't it? And then, now the demand has been increased to 800. The supply is here. The demand is 800. The supply is there. So if you draw a demand curve, if you draw a curve, see the price will be price. A small increase in the demand bring big from 8 to 13. So 8 to 13 means 5 rupees it has been increased. But the quantity has been increased only 200. The price has been increased up to 5. The increase in the price brings increase in the profit, isn't it? The price has increased, the producers, they will get more profit. Because for few goods, they are getting more price. So the increase in the price attracts the producers, others. As we studied in the perfect competition, we are studying in the perfect competition only. So in the perfect competition, there are large number of buyers and sellers we studied. Isn't it? Large number of buyers and sellers, free entry and exit. So, the profit, the increase in the price brings increase in the profit. The increased profit attracts other producers. So, they will enter into the production. They will start at producing goods. Homogeneous product, that also is studied, isn't it? Homo means same. So the product will be homogeneous. So the same product will be produced by all the people. Already some factory stores are existing there. The new producers, the new firms also enter. And they started to produce the same goods. So what would happen? The supply will be more. So, the supply will be increased. This is new supply curve. So, the new supply curve will come. The new supply curve means the demand is here. If the supply is more, automatically price will go down. See, if I draw the new supply curve, it means the demand curve here. If you draw the demand curve for the price, you will get 11 rupees or 12 rupees, maybe. The demand also increased, but the price has been increased. See, the price is so in the long run, producers will get equilibrium. At first he gets equilibrium, then it attracts other producers, so others will come into existence. So the increased product will increase the supply. Automatically the demand also, price will go down. The price goes down, the demand increases. So they will come to a equilibrium point. In the long run, how they come into equilibrium point? This is the producer's equilibrium in the long run. Will you be able to understand? At first at the prevailing price of 800, the production, the quantity demanded is 600. So we have drawn a demand curve and the short run supply curve, because we cannot change the supply in the short period. So short run supply curve I have drawn. So the meeting point is E. Then the demand has been increased to 800. The increasing demand brings an increase in the price and it brings the shifting demand curve. So the meeting point of supply and the demand curve is an equilibrium point. And then the increase in the price bring increase in the profit. That profit will attract the other producers. They also started to produce the same good. So if they started producing the same good, the supply will be increased. So if the supply increased, automatically the price comes down. If the price comes down, the demand goes up. Do you understand this? This is the long run producers equilibrium curve. You'll be able to understand. So, under perfect competition,
we have learned how the producers get equilibrium in the long run. Today let me complete this. Up to this I am going to complete this. Started reading, revising the lesson girls. Next week you are going to write your evaluation test. First 4 chapters I have given. Start revising. Don't waste your time. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the first 4 lessons. Because you got only, we have started only late. But you should concentrate on your studies, girls. Don't waste your time. If you have any doubts in your previous portions, you can ask me. And up to perfect competition, I have completed. Imperfect competition, the monopoly, monopolistic, discriminating monopoly and other things, we will learn after the test. Do you understand? So up to perfect competition I have completed. From imperfect competition, the different type of market structure, we will study, we will learn after the test. So 19th onwards, again, we will start learning the lessons. Thank you, girls.